Roadshow Kitchen. Chef Bob Burke is here. Pot Au Feu is the place. We got French Farmhouse Chicken along with figs on the menu. And tell everyone quickly why you wanted to make this today, because you just had a birthday not too long ago.
I'm an old man now.
That's all right.
And,
we love you.
I turned 60.
Yes.
And I decided what better way to do it than to go to Paris. And we went to Normandy with my two daughters and my wife. Today's my wedding anniversary.
Happy anniversary,
Annie. And it was just great. And one of the things that I absolutely loved is everywhere we went, little bistros, cafes, both Paris, Normandy, is this poulet fermier.
Okay.
And this is French farmhouse chicken.
All right.
And, I mean, it's just a staple of the menu over there. And, of course, we serve it at Pot Au Feu. And it was just, I thought, a great recipe as people getting back to school.
Right.
Looking for something simple, easy, good leftovers. Not a lot of work to get it done.
Good
stuff.
So
we're going to do the poulet fermier.
So let's see what we have here, and what kind of chicken we have here, and what pieces of the chicken we have.
You want to get about a 3 to 4 pound young chicken, mm-hmm. Okay? I get mine down at Armando's, this great meat market. I love. What a fabulous butcher. And they will cut them in half for you, but you can really pick what you want.
Okay.
Not like being in the package.
Yep.
And then what we're going to do, the secret to making a really good farmhouse chicken is the marinade. So we've got our ingredients over here. We've got a little apple cider, gives it a little sweetness. We've got some lemon juice, which is going to break down some of the muscle.
Right.
We've got a little olive oil to keep it moist. And then salt and pepper. And of course, now you got to pick a fresh herb.
Oh, that smells so good.
Today I chose rosemary.
Yeah, that really.
So this is fresh rosemary that we've chopped up. And now we're going to mix in the marinate it overnight. Pump it in the oven the next day. It's going to be delicious.
And we are good to
Fabulous.
Go. All right, sounds good. The birthday boy's with us. What else he didn't tell? He celebrated his birthday at the top of the Eiffel Tower, but we'll get to that. Back to you.
For now, we're going to go back into the kitchen with Will.
That's right. We are in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef Bob Burke is here. Pot Au Feu is the restaurant. It's one of the staple restaurants in Providence. We are ready to go. We've got some chicken. What are you doing?
I got it on my thing.
Oh, you do? Yeah, it's right there.
Yeah, yeah.
I got it's it right there. All in the advertising.
Apron.
Oh, right on your apron. All right, what do you want to do right now?
Okay, so we start off, I'd like you to prepare the marinade.
Well, I can do that.
And what we're going to do is we want about a cup and a half, so I got about, 3 or 4 ounces here.
Okay.
So what I'd like you to do is apple cider gives us a little sweetness.
Mm-hmm.
It's also going to give a touch of acid.
Got it.
And that sweetness is going to help brown the chicken a little bit because we want a nice brown poulet fermier.
Of course.
And then we're going to add some lemon juice. Lemon juice is really key in the marinade because what's going to happen now is that's
all of this? Am I adding?
Put it all in. Okay. Equal parts.
All right.
And this is what's nice about this is whether you're making just one chicken or 3 or 4, you want to do it for a big group for mm-hmm. a cookout on Labor Day, you equal parts of the apple cider, of the lemon juice, and of the oil.
Right. This is the oil right here.
Go ahead, pour
is
that right on in.
Like an olive oil? Or
yep.
Just an
you
olive
can
oil
use
in?
An olive oil, or you can use a salad oil, depending. Sometimes the olive oil can be a little heavy. But before you whisk, what I'd like you to do is add a generous portion of pepper.
Mm-hmm.
You can use black pepper here. And if you wanted to, you like something spicy?
Just I do.
A pinch of cayenne would
do that.
Go a long way in something like mm-hmm. this. Plenty of salt, okay? And now our fresh herbs. You could do any one of the fresh herbs that's in the garden. You could do a basil chicken. I chose rosemary. So we're going to go ahead and add all of the rosemary.
Got it.
Okay?
Uh-huh.
And now whisk that up good.
Okay.
Now, we've got, as you can see here's our little chicken, okay? And the chicken has been cut in half. And as I told you, I really like buying my chicken at a butcher.
From a butcher, you get?
And we get all our chicken at the restaurant from Armando's, the meat. And they've got butchers. And I ask them, I pick out the chicken I want, and I say, I want these cut in half. And they cut them to order. If you get a whole chicken, you can use poultry shears to cut it in half.
Okay, and it really works. All right, sounds good. All right, so we've got
the marinade is ready.
Here. We will talk about the restaurant, everything that Bob Burke is up to.
Put the marinade on top.
We'll pour the marinade on top.
Voila.
As we speak, back to you. Back in the Roadshow kitchen this morning, Bob Burke is on a roll. Pot Au Feu is the place. French Farmhouse Chicken plus figs, which you and I were talking about figs before. I don't think I've had figs since I was a kid. And this is a totally different ballgame. And the figs I probably had were like Fig Newtons or something.
And the reason I brought these is back to school. First of all, they're in season.
Right.
Now is the time to eat figs.
Okay.
And what I want to show you is take the figs. And here, the thing that you want to do with them is if they're hard, to tell if they're ripe, go ahead, just give them a little, pick them up, give them a little squeeze, and compare that to this one.
Okay, you can kind of feel these.
So give that, see what I mean?
This is a little harder.
So that's a little harder. So what you want to do with the fig is that the only part of the fig you can't eat is just the little nub on the top, the
right
stem, because they hang on the tree like this.
Okay.
But these are,
Oh, so you don't even, like, there's no skin?
Look at this. Isn't that beautiful?
That looks good.
Look at the cup. Bite into
it. So even like this here, you don't have to, like...
Oh, you need the skin.
I didn't know if you had to peel the skin or not.
Most kids' experience with a fig is like a fig Newton.
Mmm.
And they're sweet.
They're very sweet.
So it's almost like candy for kids. Anytime you can give kids naturally sweet...
Right.
Fruit.
They're good.
And get that in the diet, and they're just tremendous at this time of year. Right. I mean, just great. Well, here. Hold on there. Just going to eat.
Okay.
Now, we marinated our chicken.
Okay.
You can leave it overnight in the refrigerator.
Probably better to leave it overnight in the refrigerator.
Yes.
Get a little more flavor in it.
What's nice about this is we're going to go one dish because you're busy this time of year.
Right.
Not a time of year when you want to be doing a lot of dishes and making a big. So we're one dish because we made the marinade. It goes in. You're going to cover it overnight with a little saran.
Okay.
When you're ready to cook it, all you're going to have to do is take it out.
Tin foil on it.
And we're going to seal it up nice and tight because we want to get the first cooking, the first half of the cooking, which is going to be about 35 minutes, 350 in a regular oven. And what we want to do is seal in the juices. And we want to get that marinade to cook right in and moisturize so that we're really tender. The trick with this chicken is...
Yep.
Is that there's a lot of what's called collagen in chicken. You know when they have that, you buy stock collagen?
Oh, yeah. Right. Right, yeah.
Well, collagen is what breaks down into gelatin and moisturizes the chicken.
Keeps it from drying out.
So it's that nice, moist cooking that you want to get. But then at the end, we want to uncover it for the second half of the cooking.
Okay.
And what that's going to do for us is it's going to give us our nice browning.
Oh, because you want, because like you said, you wanted it to be crisp on top with the skin and everything.
Exactly. Okay. So let's, you know,
we'll seal that up.
Through the magic of television, you know, as you know, we slide this guy in the oven.
Take this one out.
And out comes our poulet fermier. Okay, smell that and tell me you don't feel like you're in a farmhouse in France. All right?
Ah, oui.
Beautifully browned. That's what we're looking for.
You get a French accent when you smell that.
Oh, my gosh, the rosemary.
It does.
And now, here's what the French do, and this is what, you know, again, it's these little tricks in French cooking. We use them all the time at the restaurant. Mm-hmm. This juice has all come out of the chicken, okay?
You don't want to get rid of it.
It's just a little bit of the marinade, and that's what's residual left, and we don't want to get rid of it.
No.
Because we're going to use that when we serve the chicken, okay? And... we get it out on the plate like this, okay?
Right.
And what we do is we actually pour it into a little pitcher, and you serve it with it. And that means that when you slice the chicken, okay, and it's this beautiful, moist chicken, what we're able to do now is we're going to put a little of the jus over it.
Ooh, that looks
okay?
Good. Yeah.
So now cutting in here, and to know your chicken's done, you want to be at 165 degrees or higher. Here in the thigh portion,
okay,
the thick thigh portion. Look how moist that
looks.
That looks great. The thing about chicken is that so many times you cut into the breast, it's dry.
Right.
And what's nice about this chicken, because we did that first half with the marinade covered, that breast is going to be delicious and moist.
All right, looks good.
Okay.
To me.
So there we go. And
that
is
that
our
breast.
Poulet fermier. There you are.
Want to have a piece of this? I'm going to give this a shot. Look at this. I mean, this looks
hot. Be careful. And...
oh, my God.
Isn't that a great...
Mm.
You know, something as simple as chicken, you think, oh, gosh, how can it ever come out differently?
That is so good.
With a recipe like this, you get it to come out differently, have a little figs for dessert.
Rock and roll. Bob Burke has done it again. Pot Au Feu is the restaurant. Check it out. If you want the recipe for this, and you will, go to roadshow.com.